to our God, glory to you. O heavenly King, O Counselor, the Spirit of Truth, who are present everywhere and filling all things, the treasure of good things and giver of life, who come and abide in us and cleanse us from every stain and save our souls, O good Lord.
Amen. Highest of Theos, highest of Theos, highest of Theos, highest of Theos, Holy God, Holy Mighty, Holy Mortal, have mercy on us. Highest of Theos, highest of Theos, highest of Theos, highest of Theos, Lux of the Theos, if never can you change, comes to me. And yet, the last place to must be lost as what there is one, that's the first of all, must be made to me. And it is the case of the sinners one, and it can come out of the tribulation, tribulation, tribulation. Lux of the Theos, if never can you change, comes to me. Father, I'm on the east, and I'm on the east, I'm on the east, I'm on the west, I'm on the east, 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 I'm on
the east, I'm on the east, I'm on the east, I'm on the east, I'm on the east, I'm on the east, I'm on the east, I'm on the east, I'm on the east, I'm on the east, I'm on the east, I'm on the east, I'm
on the east, I'm on the east, I'm on the east, I'm on the east, I'm on the east, I'm on the east, I'm on the east, I'm on the east, I'm on the east, I'm on the east, I'm on the east, I'm on the east, I'm on the east, Lord, to the Father, from the Holy Spirit, thou hast raised up on the cross, and thou knowest the will of Christ our God, so peace of the compassion upon this new commonwealth, named after thee. Thine place for our mind, most orthodox hierarchs, and by safety, the creator of false teaching, as they help and learn where they may they possess the weapon of peace to throw the invincible, both now and ever to the ages of age and end. O great protection, not be put to shame, to stay not a good one, or in trees, or himself, or us. Make that past the commonwealth, the orthodox, protect those whom thousands are to rule the rest. And grant you the victory from on high. For thou hast given birth to God, and the blessed one.
Have mercy on us, O God, according to your great mercy, we pray you hear us, and have mercy. Let us pray for pious and always for our Christians. Forgive me, pray for us, because if you ask him
all.
For you are a merciful God who loves mankind, and see, we offer glory to the Father, to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and forever, into the ages of ages.
Amen. In the name of the Lord, Father, blessed.
Glory to the holy and consubstantial and life-giving and undivided Trinity, always, now and forever, and to the ages of ages.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace
to
dwell among men. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to dwell among men. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to dwell among men. O Lord, you shall open my lips, and my mouth will declare your praise. O Lord, you shall open my lips, and my mouth will declare your praise. O Lord, my words will quickly multiply. Many are those who rise up against me. Many are those who say to my soul, there is no salvation in him and his God. But you, O Lord, are my protector, my glory, and the one who lifts up my head. I cry to the Lord with my voice, and he heard me from his holy hill. I lay down and slept. I woke, and the Lord will help me. I will not be afraid of 10,000 of people who set themselves against me all around. Arise, O Lord, and save me, O my God, for you struck all those who appreciate and appreciate. You broke the peace of sinners. Salvation is of the Lord, and your blessing is upon your people. I lay down and slept. I woke, and the Lord will help me. O Lord, do not rebuke me in your wrath, nor chasten me in your anger. Your arrows are fixed in me, your hand rests on me. There is no pain in my flesh because of your wrath. There is no peace in my bones because of my sins. For my transgressions rise up over my head as a heavy burden, they are heavy on me. My wounds grow foul and fester because of my folly. I suffer misery and I mutterly bow down. I go all the day long with a sad face, and my loins are filled with mockery, and there is no killing in my flesh. I'm afflicted and greatly humbled, O Lord, because of the groaning of my heart. O Lord, all my desire is before you, my groaning is not hidden from you. My heart is troubled, my sin fails me in the light of my eyes, even this is not with me. My friends and neighbors draw near and stand against me, and my near kin stand far off. And those who seek my soul use violence, and those who seek evil from me speak folly. I meditate on his speech all the day long, but I like a deaf man and do not hear, and I'm like a mute who does not open his mouth. I'm like a man who does not hear and who has no peace in his mouth. For you, O Lord, I hope with you, O Lord my God. For I said it, how my enemies rejoice over me, for my foot was shaken and busted against me. For I am ready for the wounds of my hands continually with me, for I will declare my transgression and I will be anxious about my sins. But my enemies live and are become stronger than I, and those who hate me justly will multiply. Those who hate me evil for good stand to me because I pursue righteousness. And they threw away my love as though it was pink and coarse. Do not forsake me, O Lord, O my God. Do not depart from me. Give thee to help me, O Lord, of my salvation. Do not forsake me, O Lord, O my God. Do not depart from me. Give thee to help me, O Lord, of my salvation. O God, my God, I rise early to be with you. My soul thirsts for you. O flesh, there is seen a desolate and impassable and darkness there. So in the holy place I appear before you to see your power and your glory, because your mercy is better than life, my lips shall praise thee. Thy salvation, my life, I lift up my hands in your name. May my soul be filled as with marrow and fatness, and my nostrils be praised to with lips filled with rejoicing. If I remember to all my bed and meditate in you at daybreak, you are my comfort and shelter of your wings, I'll greatly rejoice. My soul follows close behind you, your right hand is holding me. But they seek for my soul in vain, they should go into the lowest parts of the earth. They should be given over to the eyes of the sword, they should be a portion for foxes. But the king shall be glad in God, and all his rabbi men shall be praised, because the mouth that speaks of righteousness is stopped. I meditate with you at daybreak, for you may help with the shelter of your wings, how great and rejoice. My soul follows close behind you, your right hand is holding me. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and forever, to the ages of ages. Amen. For that mercy, God, alleluia, 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 glory to your God. Alleluia, 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 glory to your God. Alleluia, 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 glory to your God. What a mercy, what a mercy, what a mercy. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and forever, to the ages of ages. Amen. O Lord God, my salvation, I cry day and night before you. Let my prayer come before you. Incline your ear to my supplication, O Lord. For my soul is filled with sorrow, and my soul draws near to Hades. I am counted among those who look down into the pit. I am like a helpless man to be among the dead. Like slain men thrown down, sleeping in the grave, you remember no more. But they are removed in your hand, they lead you in the lowest pit, in the dark places in the shadow of death. Your wrath rested upon me, you brought all your blows over me. You removed my acquaintances far from me, you made me an abomination among themselves. I was betrayed and not go forth, my eyes weakened from poverty. O Lord, I cried from the whole day long, I set on my hands to you. We with wonder through the dead of the physician, please come up and acknowledge you. Saw anyone in the grave describe your mercy and truth and destruction. Show wonder as we know in darkness and your righteousness in the forgotten man. But I cried to the Lord in the morning, my prayer should come near to you. Why, O Lord, do you reject my soul and turn away your face from me? I am foreign and troubled from my youth, and having been exalted, I was humbled and brought to despair. Your fierce things are passed over me, your terrors greatly troubled me. They compassed me like water all the day long and surrounded me at once. You removed far from me, neighbor and friend, and my acquaintances because of their misery. O Lord God, my salvation, I cry day and night before you. Let my prayer come before you. Incline your ear to my supplication, O Lord. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and every dream within me, bless his holy name. Bless the Lord, O my soul, forget not all his rewards. Who is merciful to all your transgressions, and heals all your diseases. He redeems your life from corruption, and he crowns with mercy and compassion. He satisfies your desire with good things, and he uses the news like the eagles. The Lord shows mercy and judgment to all who are wrong, that he may know in his ways to Moses and things he wills the sons of Israel. The Lord is compassionate and merciful, slow to anger and abounding in mercy. He will not become angry to the end, nor will he be wrathful forever. He did not deal with us according to our sins, nor reward us according to our transgressions. For according to the height of heaven and from earth, so the Lord makes the mercy over those who fear him. As far as the east is from the west, so he removes our transgressions from us. As a father is compassionate on his children, so the Lord is compassionate on those who fear him. For he knows how he formed us and remembers the earth dust. As for man, he gazes like glass, as a flower of the field, so he flourishes. For the wind passes through it, and it shall not remain, and it shall no longer know its place. But the mercy of the Lord is remains to age upon those who fear him, and his righteousness upon children's children, such as keep his covenant and remember his commandments to do them. The Lord prepared a throne in heaven, and his kingdom rules over all. Bless the Lord, all his angels, mighty and strength, and to his words, those who hear the voice of his words. Bless the Lord, all his hosts, his ministries, and to his will. Bless the Lord, all his works, in all places of his dominion. Bless the Lord, O my soul. In all places of his dominion, bless the Lord, O my soul. O Lord, in my prayer, give ear to my supplication, in your truth, answer me in your righteousness. Do not enter into judgment of your servant, for no one living should become righteous in your sight. For the enemy persecuted my soul, he humbled my life to the ground. He caused me to dwell in dark places and grown long dead. And my spirit is in anguish within me, my heart is troubled within me. I remember the days of old, and I meditated in all your works. I meditated in the works of your hands. I set on my hands to you, my soul thirsts for you like a waterless land. Hear me speedily, O Lord, my spirit faints within me. Turn not your face from me, lest I become like those who go down into the pit. Cause me to hear your mercy in the morning, cry for you, make me know, O Lord, the way wherein I should walk. Deliver me from my enemies, O Lord, who do by faith the accuracy, teach me to do well for you, my God. Your good spirit to guide me in the land of uprightness, to your name, O Lord, give me life. In your righteousness, you shall bring my soul to affliction. In your mercy, you shall destroy my enemies. You shall destroy all who afflict my soul, so I am your servant. Answer me, O Lord, in your righteousness, and do not enter into judgment for your servant. Answer me, O Lord, in your righteousness, and do not enter into judgment for your servant. Your good spirit to guide me in the land of uprightness. Glory to the Father, to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, from now and forever, see you to the ages. Amen. Alleluia, 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 glory to you, O God. Alleluia, 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 glory to you, O God. Alleluia, 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 glory to you, O God. Our hope, O Lord, glory to you.
In peace let us praise the Lord.
You praise the Lord.
For the peace from above and for the salvation of our souls, let us praise the Lord.
You praise the Lord.
For the peace of the whole world, for the stability of all the churches of God, and for the unity of all, let us pray to the Lord. For this holy house, and for those who enter with faith, reverence, and the fear of God, let us pray to the Lord. For pious and Orthodox Christians, let us pray to the Lord. For our Archbishop Gerasimos, for the honorable presbyters, for the diaconate in Christ, and for all the clergy and the people, let us pray to the Lord. For our country, for the president, for all in public service, let us pray to the Lord. For this city and for every city and land, and for the faithful who live in them, let us pray to the Lord. For favorable weather, for an abundance of the fruits of the earth, and for peaceful times, let us pray to the Lord. For those who travel by land, sea, and air, for the sick, the suffering, the captives, and for their salvation, let us pray to the Lord. For our deliverance from all affliction, wrath, danger, and necessity, let us pray to the Lord. Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and protect us, O God, by your grace. Commemorating our most holy, pure, blessed, and glorious Lady,
most
all those who never virgin Mary with all the saints, let us commend ourselves and one another in our whole life through Christ our God.
To you, O Lord.
For you belong all glory, honor, and worship to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and forever, and to the ages of ages.
Amen. Thank you.
Thank you.
Father and His Son and the Holy Spirit, the Holy Trinity, one in essence, and we cry aloud with the seraphim, Holy, holy, holy are you, O Lord. Again and again in peace, let us pray to the Lord. Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and protect us, O God, by your grace. Commemorating our most holy, pure, blessed, and glorious Lady, the Theotokos and ever Virgin Mary, with all the saints, let us commend ourselves and one another in our whole life through Christ our God. For blessed is your name, and glorified is your kingdom, of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Now and forever into the ages of ages.
Amen. After your passion of Christ, God, the women went to the tomb to anoint your body. They saw angels in the sepulchre, and they were amazed when they heard them saying that you, the Lord, had risen, granting the world a great mercy.
Unto Aranota, O Marta, Ecclanto, Mrs. Cardias, Costes, Sotis, Postum, Messi, and Pinomsi. Το πατρικέιο και ο πνεύματι, ειλικέι και εις τους αιώνα των αιώνων, αμήν. Αγίο πνεύματι, το βασίλευ υπέρι, το αγιάζειν τον κοινήν την κτήσιν, Θεός καθ' εστίν, ομοούσιος πατρί και λόγον. Deliver me to the teeth of my enemy, O Savior. For in the manner of a lion, they move against me, your servant. Hope now and ever, and unto the ages of ages, amen. Those who trust in the Lord are like the holy mountain. They are in no way shaken by the devil's assault.
But those who look for God, neither stretch
out their hands in lawlessness.
For Christ will not
permit
the law to be
upon
his inheritance.
Glory to the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit.
Both now.
From the Holy Spirit, all wisdom gushes forth as the spray to the apostles. By him, martyrs are awarded for their contest, and the prophets have visions. Εξαγέθητη Κύριε ο Θεός μου εν προσταγματι ο εν εκτήλω και συναγωγούν τα ο κύκλος της θέ. Again and again in peace, let us pray to the Lord. Yeah. Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and protect us, O God, by your grace. Commemorating our most holy, pure, blessed, and glorious Lady, the Felt, all close and ever Virgin Mary, with all the saints, let us commend ourselves, most matter our whole life, through Christ our God. For you are the King of peace and the Savior of our souls, and to you we offer up glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and forever, into the ages of ages.
Amen. Omnipotent Lord, he rose from the sepulchre. The netherworld saw the miracle and was stupefied, for the dead were also raised. The creation saw it and rejoiced with you. Adam also greatly rejoiced. O my Savior, the world reigns. The world forever sings your praise. You, O Word of God, are the light of those in darkness. You are the resurrection and the life of all humanity. You destroy the power of death and smash the gates of Hades. You raised everyone with yourself. Mortals saw the miracle and marveled. All creation rejoices with you in your creation and resurrection, O benevolent Lord. So we all now glorify and extol your condescension. O my Savior, your world forever sings your praise. With one accord, we sing your praises, Father Gregory, who speaks from God, sonorous trumpet of theology and divine and sacred organ of holy wisdom. But as intellect that stands before the intellect, unto him direct our intellects unto you, we may cry aloud, rejoice, O herald of grace. As the herald of mysteries, you appeared on earth plainly, proclaiming things divine and immortal, endowed with the human mind and flesh, and yet speaking in the tongue of the bodiless. You amazed us and convinced us to cry out to you, O godly Redder. Rejoice to whom the darkness was banished, rejoice to whom the light is supplanted, rejoice who created divinities and messengers. Rejoice the computer of one created and unsensible. Rejoice you who called God's nature an inaccessible height. Rejoice you who called his energy a depth difficult to study. Rejoice that you directly have discoursed on God's glory. Rejoice that you have spoken against the views of the wicked. Rejoice that God has made the sun evident. Rejoice in the soul imparting the sweet nectar. Rejoice with whom the truth shines refulgent. Rejoice with whom was falsehood extinguished. Rejoice in the realm of grace. On March 31st, at the contest of the holy hero martyr Evagrius, Bishop of Hungary. On this day, we also commemorate our God Father Evagrius, the confessor Bishop of Manitini. On this day, we also commemorate the holy martyrs who witnessed in Persia, August, the Bishop, Benjamin, the Deacon, and nine other martyrs with them, and many other saints who were imprisoned and were eaten alive by mice and weasels and closed within them. The holy martyr Menandros reposed after being dragged naked over stones. Holy 38 martyrs, who were relatives, died by the sword. Our devout Father Blaise, born in Amorian, reposed in peace. Our devout Father Stephen, the wonder worker, reposed in peace. On this day, the second Sunday of Lent, we observe the memory of our Father among the saints, Gregory Palamas, Archbishop of Thessalonica. The mind fully grazed, and the light's bright arrow is led by light and forced to radiance never setting. By his intercessions of God, have mercy on us and save us from God.
Αληθώ το στόμα μου και θυλωθήστε τεφνεύματος και λόγον ερεύσω με τη Βασιλεία Δημήτρη και οφίστω με πέδρος πανηγυρίζων και αφογηθώ με να στάθει τα θαύματα. Establish your servants who extol you, O Mother of God, for they have formed a spiritual choir for you, the living and abundant font, and graciously in your divine glory, give glorious thanks to them. In an exignias on Theon Volin, his sectis parthenus arcoseos, tutuitis tuo profitis abacum, catano and ecrogas, the fetid dynamis to Kyrie. Amazed was the universe by your divine magnificence. You who were perpetually virgin carried the heavenly God of all in your womb and gave her to the eternal Son, who offered salvation to all who sing hymns of praise to you. In the undoubting Kepandimon, the Lundes de Ordini Theophrones, Tiste Omitoros, Epteta Spira Trotis Omen, Don Exta Christus sexen, date on doxazon des.
That in mind is created, and adore created things, in the Creator's sight, rather disdaining the threat of fire, they trampled it, and they joyfully they sang, O supremely praised and most exalted Lord and God, of the Father's human blessing.
Domen of the government, get crossing domen, sanctirion, preda, sevagis, and the camino, oco, cositeo, toku, dies, sosato, totementi, humanos, nine energumenos, inicumen, in a pasana, irisolusan, sanctirion, in iteta erga, que iperitute,
let us pray to the Lord. For you are holy, our God, who rests among the saints, and to you we offer up glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and forever, and to the ages of ages.
Let everything that we pray the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Let everything that breathes praise the Lord.
Wisdom arise, let us hear the holy gospel. Peace be with all. The reading is from the holy gospel according to John. Let us be attentive.
Glory to you, Lord, glory to you.
At that time, Jesus revealed himself again to the disciples by the Sea of Tiberias, and he revealed himself in this way. Simon Peter, Thomas called the twin, Nathanael of Cana in Galilee, the sons of Zebedee, and the two others of his disciples were together. Simon Peter said to them, I am going fishing. They said to him, we will go with you. They went out and got into the boat, but that night they caught nothing. Just as day was breaking, Jesus stood on the beach, but the disciples did not know that it was Jesus. Jesus said to them, children, have you any fish? They answered him, no. He said to them, cast the net on the right side of the boat, and you will find some. So they cast it, and now they were not able to haul it in for the quantity of fish. The disciple whom Jesus loved said to Peter, it is the Lord. When Simon Peter heard that it was the Lord, he put on his clothes, for he was stripped for work, and sprang into the sea. But the other disciples came into the boat, dragging the net full of fish, for they were not far from the land, but about 800 yards off. When they got out on the land, they saw a charcoal fire there, with fish lying on it and bread. Jesus said to them, bring some of the fish that you have just caught. So Simon Peter went aboard and hauled the net ashore, full of large fish, 153 of them. And although there were so many, the net was not torn. Jesus said to them, come and have breakfast. Now none of the disciples dared ask him, who are you? They knew it was the Lord. Jesus came and took the bread and gave it to them, and so with the fish. There was now the third time that Jesus was revealed to the disciples after he was raised from the dead.
Glory to you, Lord, glory to you. Having beheld the resurrection of Christ, let us worship the Holy Lord Jesus, the only sinless one. Your cross, O Christ, we venerate in your holy resurrection we praise and glorify. For you are our God, apart from you we know no other. We call upon your name, come all faithful, let us venerate the holy resurrection of Christ. For behold, through the cross, joy has come to the whole world. Ever blessed the Lord, let us praise the resurrection for having endured the cross for us to destroy death and death. Have mercy on me, O God, according to your great mercy, and according to the abundance of your compassion, blot out my transgression.
For my lawlessness and
cleanse me
from my sin.
For I know my lawlessness, and my sin is always before me.
Against you only have I sinned and done evil in your
wash me in thy looking me whiter than snow.
You shall make me hear joy and gladness, and my bones that were humble shall greatly rejoice.
Turn your face from my sins, and blot out all my transgressions.
Create in me a clean heart, O God, and renew a right spirit within me.
Do not cast me away from your presence, and do not take your Holy Spirit from me.
Restore to me the joy of your salvation, and uphold me with your guiding spirit.
I will cease transgressing your ways, and of the ungodly shall turn back to you.
Deliver me from blood guiltiness, O God, the God of my salvation, and my tongue shall greatly rejoice in your righteousness.
O Lord, you shall open my lips, and my mouth will declare your praise.
For if you desire sacrifice, I would give it. You will not be pleased with full burnt offering.
Sacrifice to God is a broken spirit, a broken and humble heart, God will not despise.
Do good, O Lord, in your good pleasure to Zion, and let the walls of Jerusalem be built.
Then you will be pleased with the sacrifice of righteousness, with offerings and corporate offerings.
Then shall they offer love on your altar and have mercy on me.
Glory to the Father and to the Son and to the Holy Spirit. Open to me the gates of Giver of life, for early in the morning, my spirit hastens to your holy temple, bringing the temple of my body.
Oh,
Raise your Orthodox Christians in glory and send down upon us your abundant mercy and the intercessions of all, dear Lady of the Veiled, the office of the Virgin Mary, the power of the precious life giving cross, the protection of the honorable heavenly body this power, supplications of the honorable glorious prophet and forerunner John the Baptist, the holy glories of raised with the apostles, our fathers among the saints, the hierarchs, and great ecumenical teachers, Basil the Great, Gregory the Theologian, John Chrysostom, Athanasius, Cyril, and John, the merciful patron of Alexandria, Nicholas, Bishop of Amida, Stephen, Bishop of Prometheus, the Gods, the Godless, the Wonder Workers, the holy, glorious, great martyrs, George, the triumphant, Prometheus, the merciful, Theodore, the soldier, Theodore, the general, Minas, the Wonder Worker, Palamas, the Methodios, the holy priest martyrs, the holy, glorious, victorious martyrs, the glorious, great martyr, Athenia, Holy Voice, Mars, Tesla, Barbara, the Catholic, the Ancient, the Marina, Baraska, the Anarion, of our venerable God, bearing fathers, and the holy righteousness of Mary, Joachim, and Anna, of our father, and the saints, Gregory, Palamas, Archbishop of the Swan, the Jesus, Mary, we speak today, and of all your saints, we beseech you, the animals, most the Lord, listen to us in this faith, you have mercy upon us.
Media, nice one, media, nice one, media, nice one.
Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy.
Kyrie eleison, Kyrie eleison, Kyrie eleison.
Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy.
Through the mercy, compassion, and love of mankind, of your only begotten Son, with whom you are blessed, together with your all holy and life-giving Spirit, now and forever, and into the ages of ages.
Amen.
With honor and magnifying song, the Theotokos, the mother of the light, the Theotokos, and give me the Nathapatos, and give me the one that's Megalinomen.
Megalinomen, and give me the Nathapatos, and give me the Nathapatos, and give me the
For
he has regarded the lowly state of his maidservant, for me pulled henceforth on
Sedoxasi kirie, ofti dia
Christa dexis tis laetin et necron tua nasasin os monos philanthropos.
Praise God in his name, praise him in the firmament of his power. Let thy Jewish leaders explain it. How did the soldiers lose the king whom they were guarding? Why couldn't the storm so clear the walk of life? I therefore do say who was studied, for a person him arising from the dead. Let all us say, glory to the abundance of your tender mercies, of Savior, glory to you.
And it upon the pieces of mysterious doctor, and it upon Catatoplistos is megalosthenes aftu, erete laike aganiaste, angelos ekatisem histonikon tuplimatos, aftos imas evangelis pato ipon, Christos anesti ek nekron obsotitu kosmum ke et liros et asimbanda evo dias eret elaike agani asem.
The sound of trumpet, haste with the harp and choir. Before your conception, an angel brought the salutation. Rejoice to the maiden full of grace. Again your resurrection, an angel rolled away the stone from your glorious tomb. Oh, Lord, the one who brought a promise of joy, we praise thee in the passing sorrow. The other mighty words that the Master gives life, we bear in the threat of death. Therefore we sing to you, Lord, the benefactor of all glory.
Αυτόν εσύ πάνω και χωρώ, εν είτε αυτόν εν σπερδές και οργάνω, την μακαρίαν εν κόσμο ζωήν δίνησας, και νυν των μακαρίων την επένη της λίβης, και γιν την των πράεων ως πράωθηκης, ιερά καθηγόριε. Χαρήν θαυμάτων πλουτίστε παρά Θεού, ειν παρέκειστον θυμώσθησε. Praise him with the sounding cymbals, praise him with triumphant cymbals, let everything that breathes praise the Lord, while in the world you attain to a life of blessedness. And now you are exulting with the ranks of the blessed, and dwell, O Bishop Gregory, in the land of the meek, being meek yourself. And you are rich in God's miracle-working grace, which you grant to those who honor you. O Maria che apostasi Sophia, ili dandon, epistam de caritas, orthodoxia sa dogmata, catepitetas, cacodoxias maca, ecce montas acantas, cepisteos ons forum tristinas calos, et ombria con logon sum, et catos devon de sahinos practicos, Hierosteo proscinengas. O Lord, your priests clothe themselves in righteousness, your saints shall greatly rejoice, the ranks of angels and mankind marvel, O blessed one, at the illustrious glory of your life which was blameless. For as a steadfast athlete by your resolve, you distinguish yourself indeed. As an ascetic and hierarch of God, a worthy minister and genuine friend.
Blessed are you, O Lord, teach me your statutes of old. You created me from nothing and honored me with your divine image. But when I disobeyed your commandment, O Lord, you cast me
down to the earth from where I was taken. Lead me back again to your likeness and renew my original beauty.
Blessed are you, Lord, teach me your statutes. I am an image of your ineffable glory. Though I bear the scars of my transgressions on your creation, Master, take pity and cleanse me by your compassion. Grant me the home for which I long, and once again make me a citizen of paradise.
Ευλογητός τη Κυρία διδαξόμεθα δικαιώματός σου, αναπαυθόν ο Θεός του δούλου σου και κατάταξον αυτούς εν παραδείσου, όπου χωρί τον Αγίον Κύριε και οι δικαίοι εκλάμψουν στην αυτοστήρες, τους πεκοιμημένους δούλους του αναπαυθόν παραρωνατών πάντα τα εγκλήματα.
The Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, the threefold radiance of the one God, let us praise, let us shout out in song. Holy are you, eternal Father, co-eternal Son, and divine and Holy Spirit. Deliver us from eternal fire, those who worship you.
Now and forever and to the ages of ages, amen. Rejoice, gracious Lady, who for the salvation of all gave birth to God in the flesh, and through whom the human race has found salvation. Through you, pure and blessed Theotokos, may we find paradise.
Alleluia, 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 Lord, first be your Theotokos.
Alleluia, 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 glory to you, O God.
Alleluia, 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 Lord, first be your Theotokos.
May the Lord God place their souls where the righteous repose. Let us ask the mercies of God, the kingdom of heaven, and the forgiveness of their sins from Christ, our immortal King and God.
Grant us, O Lord.
Let us pray to the Lord. as your purple down death and have abolished the power of the devil, giving life to your world. We rest on the souls of your departed servants, Vestal, George, Inica, George, George, Elaine, John, Bill, Joby, Ioanni, Elizabeth, Nicholas, Anna, Apostolos, Kern, Itali, Lafu, Victor, Zoe, Ciro, and Jorge. In a place of life, in a place of repose, in a place of refreshment, in a place where there is no pain, sorrow, and suffering. As a good and loving God, we give every sin they may have committed in thought, word, or deed. For there is no one who lives in this room. You alone are without sin, your righteousness is an everlasting righteousness, and your word is true. You are the resurrection of life, and you are the departed servant of Christ our God. And you give glory to your Father everlasting. You're all holy, good, and loving, and spirit, now and forever, and to the ages.
The resurrection, life, and repose of your departed servants of Christ, our God, and you to give glory to your Father and your holy, good, and life giving Spirit, now and forever, into the ages of ages.
Amen.
May memory be to know the sisters and brothers worthy of blessedness and everlasting memory. Amen. Of men, not on a mercy, he said,
Palamas Domin, genit angiri et eleos anemas, catate bis domen epicem, ella idus nitia, ella sonia, ad in nevo natatum, blessed art thou, Lord, blessed Lord, teach me thy commandments, avoid all sin in
Amen.
Sophia patros, etium, et laiute patros, in te aim, teisis eonas, ton eonos. In peace let us pray to the Lord. In the peace of God and the salvation of our souls, let us pray to the Lord. Stability of the Holy Church of God and for the union of all, let us pray to the Lord.
For this holy house and for those who end with faith, reverence, and the fear of God, let us pray to the Lord. For pious and Orthodox Christians, let us pray to the Lord. For Archbishop Yeras and all for the honorable presbyter, for the diaconate in Christ, and for all the clergy and the people, let us pray to the Lord.
For our country, the president, and all those in public service, let us pray to the Lord. The great and holy Church of Christ, for our holy archdiocese, for this holy metropolis, for this city and town, for every city and town, for the faithful women in them, let us pray to the Lord. For beautiful weather and abundance of the fruits of the earth and for temperate seasons, let us pray to the Lord.
For those who travel by land, sea, and air, for the sick, the suffering, the captives, and for their salvation, let us pray to the Lord. Lord, deliver us from all affliction, wrath, danger, and necessity. Let us pray to the Lord. Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and protect us, O God, by your grace.
Remembering our most holy and dear, blessed and glorious Lady, the veil of all those ever Virgin Mary, with all the saints, let us commit ourselves and one another and our whole life to Christ our God. You belong all glory, honor, and worship to the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, now and forever, and in the ages of ages.
Ευλογή ψυχή των Κυρίων και πάντα των δόσμων το όνομα το Άγιον Αυτόν.
Bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all his rewards.
Κύριος εν του ουρανού, ετοίμαστε τον θρόνο αυτού και βασιλεία του πάντων δεσπόζει.
Έφυγε την ειρήνη των Κυρίου Δεϊτώνα. Αντιλαβούς τόσο να λέεις τον Κυρία φύλαξ των ημάς ο Θεός και συγχάρηση. Της Παναγίας εκφάνου προπλογημένης των δόξα δεσποινής ημών Θεοτόκου και υπέθερ Μαρίες με τα πάντα των Αγίων μηνονάσταντες έως τους και αλλήλους και πάσαν την ζωή μου Χριστό του Θεό αφαιρεθόμεθα. Ότι στον κράτος και εις του εστίν η βασιλεία και η δύναμη και η δόξα του Πατρός και Κύριου του Αγίου Πνεύματος νυν και αΐ και εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων.
Praise the Lord, O my soul, I shall praise the Lord while I live. I shall sing to my God as long as I exist.
Μακάριες του ο Θεός Ιακώβ, βοηθός αυτού, ελπίς αυτού επί Κύριον των Θεών αυτού.
The Lord shall reign forever, your God, O Zion, who art in our nation.
protect us, O God, by your grace. Remembering our most holy, dear, blessed, and glorious Lady, the Theotokos, and the Virgin Mary, with all the saints, let us commend ourselves and one another and our whole life through Christ our God. Good loving God, and you give glory to the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, now and forever, and to the ages of ages.
Amen. This is the day the Lord made. Let us greatly rejoice and be glad therein.
Sophia,
thank you.
For you are God, our holy, and to you we offer glory to the Father, to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and forever, and in the ages of ages.
Salvation. The Lord chastened and corrected me, but he did not give me up to death.
Wisdom.
The reading is from St. Paul's letter to the Hebrews.
Let us be attentive.
In the beginning, Lord, you founded the earth, and the heavens are the work of your hand. They will perish, but you remain. They will wear out like clothing. Like a cloak, you will roll them up, and like clothing, you will be changed. But you are the same, and your ears will never end. But to what angel he has ever said, sit at my right hand until I make your enemies a footstool for your feet? Are they not all ministering spirits sent forth to serve for the sake of those who are to obtain salvation? Therefore, we must pay closer attention to what we have heard,
lest we drift away from it. For if the message declared by the angels was valid, and every transgression or disobedience receives a just retribution, how shall we escape if we neglect such a great salvation? It was declared at first by the Lord, and it was attested to us by those who heard it. He received what was promised. Since God has foreseen something for us set apart from us, they should not be made first.
It is the ABC of the reader. Wisdom arise, let us hear the Holy Gospel. Peace be with all. Reading is from the Holy Gospel according to Mark. Let us be attentive. At that time, Jesus entered Capernaum, and it was reported that he was at home, and many were gathered together, so that there was no longer room for them, not even about the door. And he was preaching the word to them. And they came, bringing to him a paralytic carried by four men. And when they could not get near him because of the crowd, they removed the roof above him. And when they had made an opening, they let down the pallet on which the paralytic lay. And when Jesus saw their faith, he said to the paralytic, "My son, your sins are forgiven." Now some of the scribes were sitting there, questioning in their hearts, "Why does this man speak thus? It is a blasphemy. Who can forgive sins but God alone?" And immediately Jesus, perceiving in his spirit that they thus questioned within themselves, said to them, "Why do you question us in your hearts? Which is easier, to say to the paralytic, 'Your sins are forgiven,' or to say, 'Rise, take up your pallet and walk'? But that you may know that the Son of Man has authority on earth to forgive sins," he said to the paralytic, "I say to you, rise, take up your pallet and go home." And he rose and immediately took off the pallet and went out before them all, so that they were all amazed and glorified God, saying, "We never saw anything like
by your power, may you glory to you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, now and forever, and to the ages of ages. Let us pray to the Lord. 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 Let us pray for a good account and for the awesome judgment seat of Christ, let us ask the Lord. Bring our most holy, dear, blessed and glorious Lady, the veil of Dolphus and ever Virgin Mary, with all the saints, let us commit ourselves and one another and our whole life to Christ our God.
To the mercies of your only begotten Son, with whom you are blessed, together with your holy, good, and life-giving Spirit, now and forever, in the ages of ages. Let us love one another that with oneness of mind we may confess.
The doors, the doors, guard the doors. In wisdom let us be.
I believe in one God, Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth, and of all things visible and invisible, and in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, begotten of the Father before all ages, light of life, true God, begotten not created, of one essence with the Father, through whom all things were made, who for us and for our salvation came down from heaven, and was incarnate of the Holy Spirit, and the Virgin Mary, and became man. He was crucified for us under Pontius Pilate, and suffered and was buried, and he rose on the third day according to the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come again with glory to judge the living and the dead. His kingdom shall have no end. And in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the Creator of life, who proceeds from the Father, who together with the Father and the Son is worshipped and glorified, who spoke through the prophets, in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church, I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. I look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the age to come. Amen.
Let us stand well, let us stand in awe, let us be attentive and present the holy offering in peace. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God the Father and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with all. Lift up our hearts.
Sing the triumphal hymn, exclaiming, proclaiming, and saying.
God and Father, and offering thanks, blessings, sanctifying and breaking it, He gave it to his holy disciples and apostles, saying, "Take and eat, this is my body, which is broken for you, for the forgiveness of sins." Likewise, he took the cup of the fruit of the vine, and having mingled it, offering thanks, blessing, and sanctifying it, he gave it to his holy disciples and apostles, saying, "Drink of this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, shed for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins." This remembrance of me, it was all beneath this bread and drink this cup, you proclaim my death and confess my resurrection. Therefore, Master, we also remember this saving passion, life giving cross, this 3-day burial from the dead, his ascension into heaven, and enthronement at your right hand, God and Father, and his glorious and awesome second coming. We offer to you these gifts from your own gifts in all and for all the sight I prospero menga da panda, genia panda. Therefore, most holy Master, we also, your sinful and unworthy servants, whom you have made worthy to serve at your holy altar, not because of our own righteousness, for we have not done anything good upon the earth, but because of your mercy and compassion, which you have so richly poured upon us, we dare to approach your holy altar and bring forth the symbols of the holy body and blood of your Christ. We pray to you and call upon you, O Holy of Holies, that by the favor of your goodness, your Holy Spirit may come upon us and upon the gifts you have presented, to bless, sanctify, and make this bread to be the precious body of our Lord and God and Savior, Jesus Christ.
Amen.
And that which is in this cup, the precious blood of our Lord, God, and Savior, Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Shed for the life and salvation of the world.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
Most holy, pure, blessed, and glorious Lady, the Throughout, O Most and Ever Virgin Mary.
Thank you.
should get out of the wars. Grant that he may serve your holy churches in peace. Keep him safe, honorable, and healthy for many years, rightly teaching the word of your truth.
Remember those whom each one of us has in mind and all the people. Grant that with one mouth and with one heart we glorify and praise your most honorable and majestic name, of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, now and forever, and to the ages of ages. In the mercy of our great God and Savior Jesus Christ, be with you all. Having commemorated all the things again and again in peace, let us pray to the Lord. For the precious gifts you presented, let us pray to the Lord. That our God, who loves mankind, having accepted them at his holy and celestial and mystical altar as an offering of spiritual fragrance, may return to God upon us the divine grace and the gift of the Holy Spirit, let us pray. Having asked for the unity of the faith and for the communion of the Holy Spirit, let us commend ourselves and one another and our whole life through Christ our God.
And make us worthy, Master, with confidence without fear of condemnation, to dare call you the Heavenly God, Father, and to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Blessed and Lord.
Let us bow our heads to the Lord.
By the grace and mercy and love for us of your only begotten Son, with whom you are blessed, together with your all holy good and life-giving Spirit, now and forever, and into the ages of ages. The holy gifts for the holy people of God.
Thank you.
I believe and confess, Lord, that you are truly the Christ, the Son of the living God, who came into the world to save sinners, of whom I am the first. I also believe that this is truly your pure body, and that this is truly your precious blood. Therefore, I pray to you, have mercy upon me, and forgive my transgressions, voluntary and involuntary, in word and deed, known and unknown, and make me worthy without condemnation to partake of your pure mysteries, for the forgiveness of sins and for life eternal. Amen. How shall I, who am unworthy, enter into the splendor of your saints? If I dare to enter into the bridal chamber, my clothing will accuse me, since it is not a woman's honor. And being bound up, I shall be cast out by the angels. In your love, Lord, cleanse my soul and save me. Loving Master, Lord Jesus Christ, my God, let not these holy gifts be my condemnation because of my unworthiness, but for the cleansing and sanctification of both soul and body, and the pledge of the future life and kingdom. It is good for me to cling to God and to place in Him the hope of my salvation. Receive me today, O Son of God, as a partaker of your mystical supper. I will not reveal your mystery to your adversaries, nor will I give you a kiss as did Judas. But as a thief, I confess to you, Lord, remember me in your kingdom.
Thank you.
to the fear of God, faith and love draw near. Hallelujah.
Pharaoh, et in digna minnatus istalasta, ericlas, alleluia. Oti istoneona, to eleos tatu, alleluia. Oti agagondistonon launatu, et in erimo, alleluia. Oti istoneona, to eleos tatu, alleluia. O pataxan di basilis megalan us, alleluia. Oti istoneona, to eleos tatu, alleluia. E apostinan di basilis Gateus, alleluia. Oti istoneona, to eleos tatu, alleluia. Consium basilea ton amoreon, alleluia. Oti istoneona, to eleos tatu, alleluia. Et honor basilea eis vastan, alleluia. Oti istoneona, to eleos tatu, alleluia. Et honditi ginnaton, lirona mia, alleluia. Oti istoneona, to eleos tatu, alleluia. Lirona mia, Israel, dolua tu, alleluia. Oti istoneona, to eleos tatu, alleluia. Oti entita pinosi imon, emnisi imon, Kyrios, alleluia. Oti istoneona, to eleos tatu, alleluia. Elitros atoimas ekton nekronimon, alleluia. Oti istoneona, to eleos tatu, alleluia. Odilus trophi, pastistaki, alleluia. Oti istoneona, to eleos tatu, alleluia. Lex homologis et osteo, tu uranu, alleluia. Oti istoneona, to eleos tatu, alleluia. Thank you. the Lord is great. Alleluia. Thanks for Kyrios. He wants part of the
give, Lord, ye something Deuteronomy unto, save, O Lord, your people, and bless your inheritance. Always, now, and forever, into the ages of ages. Arise, having partaken of the divine, holy, pure, immortal, heavenly life, creating and awesome mysteries of Christ, let us worthily give thanks to the Lord. Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and protect us, O God, by your grace. Having prayed for a perfect, holy, peaceful, and sinless day, let us commend ourselves and one another and our whole life to Christ our God. For you are sanctification and duty of glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and forever, and to the ages of ages.
Let us depart in peace, and let us pray to the Lord. Lord, bless those who praise you, and sanctify those who trust in you. Save your people and bless your inheritance. Protect the whole body of your church. Sanctify those who love the beauty of your house. Glorify them and return by your divine power. Do not forsake us who hope in you. Grant peace to your world, to your churches, to the clergy, to those in public service, to the armed forces, and to all your people. Every good and perfect gift is from above, coming from you, the Father of lights. He will give glory, thanksgiving, and worship to the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, now and forever, to the ages of ages. The Lord and His mercy come upon you through His divine grace and love, always, now, and forever, to the age of ages. Amen. Glory to you, O God, our hope, glory to you. May Christ, our true God, as the rose from the dead, the good, loving, and merciful God, have mercy upon us and save us, and be intercession for the most pure and holy Mother. The power of personal life giving cause the protection of the honorable body and the powers of heaven, the supplications of the honorable, glorious prophet, and the Lord, are known about. Holy glory, so finish with your cause, the Holy Ghost, and our waters, our holy and God, great Father. Through the prayers of our holy fathers, O Lord Jesus Christ, our God, have mercy upon us and save us. We have fallen to my guilt, but never anymore. Please be yourself out and lay strong your souls on the wall. Holy Trinity, come to all of you. God bless you. Please be seated. We have quite a few visitors with us today. First and foremost, we have Father Anthony Cornett, who serves here very generously and very hard during a difficult time in COVID and everything, and served the cathedral very well. And now he's in Tacoma. Father, welcome back. It's nice to have you and you and your beautiful family and your four daughters who are here and who are chanting this morning as well. God bless you. Thank you.
Thank you.
We have Iris de la Rosa from Sherman Oaks, James Urkel from L.A., Athena Alcal from Colorado Springs, Colorado, Samantha Lassie's family from Sydney, Australia, Athena Easy from Sydney, Australia, Violet from Damion from Athens, Greece, Kitty Karameni from Athens, Greece, Dr. Charlie Scholler from Camarillo, California, Daphne Paranos from Tacoma, Washington, the Montanian family from Tacoma, Washington, and Alan from University Place, Washington. We welcome all of you here, and all of you from Burbank as well. We welcome all of you who have come out here to be with us as well. A few announcements this morning before the sermon. We have a reminder that we need volunteers for the Easter picnic on Easter Sunday. If you're here today thinking today's Easter, I have an explanation for you later on. But today is not Easter Sunday for the Orthodox, but Happy Easter for those who celebrate it. But on our Easter Sunday, May 5th, which I'm calling Cinco de Pascua, we need volunteers at the Easter picnic on Easter Sunday to work at the food booth. Please see Stephanie and Daniel during coffee hour to sign up for all of those things. If you have not yet heard Our own Marcelo John Souza will be ordained to the Holy Diaconate next Saturday. And on Sunday, a week from today, will be elevated to the rank of priesthood as well. You're all going to have to get used to something. His baptismal name is John. So if you ask for Father John, you just might get him instead of Father Baptist. So we're going to have to figure this one out. It'll be the first thing that we work on, but Father John Marcelo Souza will be your title a week from today at this time. May God bless you, watch over you, and protect you. Please pray for him as we begin to prepare for an awesome sacrament, and pray for all the clergy as we strive to celebrate and serve the best we can for all of you and for our souls as well. It's going to be an exciting service. We have Bible studies this week. We have the YAL conference in the summer. We have a vacation week. I know we don't, not yet. We're thinking about it. But we're doing St. Sophia summer camp this summer, and we're also doing family camp as well. We also have two sponsorships or scholarships for Ionian Village. If anybody wants to go to Ionian Village, if you're in 9th, 12th grade, and you have never been to Greece, and you would like to go to Greece, or even if you have been to Greece and you want to go partake of the service at Ionian Village, please see me and we'll get you see if we can get you a scholarship to go on out for that. We thank everybody for being here, and we have pre-sanctified liturgy on Wednesday night, and the third salutation coming up Friday evening as well. So, excellent. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, amen. My grandmother, my uncle and aunt are all memorialized over here, and great family friends as well, people that I grew up with. And you know, from these wonderful people, we get wonderful advice. And one of the most memorable pieces of advice that I got from a grandmother, I think it was my wife's grandmother, said that she can tell a person's character by the people that you hang out with. She can understand your character by the very people that you hang out with. Think about that. How true is that? How true would it be if instead of somebody meeting you, they meet your friends, the people that you associate with, and they make the determination about your character based on these people? If I were the paralytic today, I would be very pleased and proud to have friends like Jesus in the gospel passage. Mind you, this is not a parable. This actually happened. And I know that we have lots of writers and industry people here, filmmakers. If you want to steal this idea, it's all yours. Just thank me when you get an award. What happens in between the lines of Scripture? What happens in between the time of things that we don't read? We get a good description, but oftentimes there are things that we don't read. And in this gospel passage, one thing that we skip over when we read it so quickly is that this was Jesus' home. He was at home teaching. He wasn't in the synagogue. He wasn't outside the temple. He wasn't on the mount. He wasn't sitting outside Golgotha. He wasn't standing outside of 7-Eleven. He was at his home teaching. And four friends pick up their buddy who was paralyzed and take him to Christ. Who are these four friends? I can tell you their names. You want to know their names? The first one is persistence. The second one is priority. The third one is humility. And the last one is connection. These are the four friends that we all need to have in our lives. It's very much said that you need to have less Lincoln friends and more Washington friends. You know what that means? Lincoln is on the penny. You don't need a lot of penny friends. You don't need 100 little friends all around you. You need four solid quarters Washington friends around you. Four friends. Persistence, priority, humility, and connection. Persistence is the guide that says we can do this. Come on. It's time. We've heard all these stories about this Jesus. We need to get him over there. Let's go. You have a fifth friend who would be Mother Gary standing on the side saying, it's not going to work. There's too many people. But persistence is saying, no, we're going to go. We're going to take him over there, and we're going to be part of that. Persistence is the friend that comes to you when you're in doubt, when you need encouragement, when you need to keep going and feel like giving up. That's where your friend persistence comes in. And a lot of times, when life gets hard, we want to give up. But persistence is the friend that tells you, don't give up. Keep going. Don't let the things that you think are going to keep you from being with Christ, barriers, the crowd, the Pharisees, all these things were barriers of persistence. Encourage them to help pick up and take him away towards the Lord. The second friend is priority. Priority is the guy who says, this is important. This is the one we have to go to. This is what's important in life. This is what our priority is to come to Christ when we're weak, when we need fulfilling, when we need to be lifted up and given strength. That's our priority. A lot of times we put other things in front of God. Priority tells us to detach ourselves from those things that hold us back and to make God our number one priority in our life. Our third friend is humility. Because sometimes we think, I don't need to go to Christ. I got it all. I'm good. I'm fine. Everything's all right. Family's healthy. Kids are good. This Sunday morning, we're going to Denver. Lent. I'll be here for Holy Week. Humility is the one who takes it from yourself and realizes that God is who you need to bow down to. Humility takes away all pride and self-ego and banishes it away and realizes that we're servants of that God, the God who sacrificed for us. And the last friend is connection. You know that there's a new pandemic these days, violent pandemic that they're talking about. I know you, everybody got PTSD when I said that word. There's a new pandemic. Honestly, it's called loneliness. There are a lot of people suffering from loneliness these days. That's what COVID did to us, was it isolated us and kept us from our communities. Connection is the friend that puts you in the presence of God, who says, you know what, it doesn't matter about the crowd, it doesn't matter about the room, it doesn't matter about anything, let's go. Persistence, priority, humility, and connection to a community. The young adults, Marcelo and I had a great conversation just last Wednesday night. We were talking about monasticism. And we were telling and explaining that even the monks who live in the seats in the cave have to be connected to the community. They can't live by themselves. They have to be connected to a greater community. You can't be a Christian and live by yourself. This paralyzed man, thank God he was connected. He was on the bed. He couldn't move. For whatever reason, he was paralyzed. And look at how God saved him with his four friends of persistence, priority, humility, and connection. He doesn't say you're healed, get up and walk. He says your sins are forgiven. Your sins are forgiven. See, sometimes it's the spiritual that is ailing us physically. And so we realize that there are persistence issues in our lives, that God is not a priority, that we've not humbled ourselves, that we haven't made a proper connection to a community. We need to enter into a relationship with Christ that brings us spiritual awakening, spiritual realization that no matter what we do, everything we do should be forgotten. I can tell you story after story of my grandmother and my aunt, who, by the way, my aunt Anna always wanted me to go to Harvard. When I was at the seminary in Boston, I went to Harvard. I bought a t-shirt. We didn't have cell phones then. I found a payphone and I called and told her I'm at Harvard. The best I could do. They want what's best for us. All of us together have to have those old friends in order to live a life in Christ. Today is the day that the church tells us that when we are paralyzed and laying on our mat, that we need to be persistent in our relationship to God. We need to be humble. We need to make it a priority. And we need to have a connection. Amen. May the Lord our God watch over and protect you always. I don't know if I made a. Did I tell you that Marcelo's getting ordained next week? Come here, Marcelo. I saw him smile when he told us he was getting married. Then I saw him walking on clouds when he got married. Ever since we gave him the news that he's getting ordained, I think there's wings growing back there, and he's starting to fly. I want you to stand in the back there and greet everybody, okay? Let me tell you, go ahead, I appreciate that. I don't mind talking in the church. Marcelo was once a pastor of a Protestant denomination, and it was a very healthy denomination. If I say anything wrong, tell me, all right? It was a very healthy denomination. He started reading about the fathers of the Greek Orthodox Church, and he realized that what he was preaching, what he was practicing, wasn't the fullness of the faith. And he went and found an Orthodox Church and left that life. Could you imagine leaving your congregation because you found the truth? And slowly in these last 20 years, 15 or so years, he's been bringing some of those friends from that community with him into the Orthodox Church. Two Masters of Divinity and almost two PhDs. Oh, one? All right. Father, Doctor. If you want to talk to Marcelo about answering the calling and following the will of God, this is what you see. As a man who, no matter what age in his life, has realized that God has called him to call, has called him to serve, and his persistence, his priorities, connection, and humility is what makes him a good man. So before the bishops get here, before they start talking and keeping us here all afternoon, I want to be the person to say, God bless you. God bless you. All right, boys. Father Anthony. Another one.